It's my pleasure to have been involved in a saga called Battlestar Galactica. Probably one of the most fun projects I was ever associated with. I guess I was influenced by a number of things growing up. You know, I have Mormon origins, but always fascinated by the theories of things, for example, Greek mythology and the pyramids. I loved von Daniken's Chariot of the Gods. I got fascinated by all those themes, and what emerged was Battlestar Galactica. The fun of this was, let's have these people running from a super race that got out of control, a race of machines. They decide to chase us, and we virtually wind up with a wagon train heading out across space and looking for what they hope would be the planet Earth. It takes a long time to get there, and you have a long time to explore on your way and play out some interesting stories. There's all kinds of theories that you can develop. Are we the results of humanoids coming here at some point, whether they mated with mates or they experimented? There's a lot to be said for the fact that there was a mother civilization long before the Egyptians, similarly the Aztecs and some of the other great tribes and so forth. But there didn't seem to be much cross-pollinization between these tribes. It's as if there was a greater source of knowledge. And whether it was Antarctica back down where it belonged as Atlantis or something else, it's reasonable to believe that a planet billions of years old may have floated a civilization or two that was very, very advanced. Well, I once thought to myself, what if heaven is the name of a planet? What if that's where our greater God is that built us such as we are?
Kobal?
Yes. Mother world of all humans, where life began.
My position on that is that we are robots of a higher God. We are a series of pumps and wiring, much like any other creature that's been created somehow. And we now have the complete DNA recipe for a human being as we know them. I mean, you know, we can now duplicate organs, and do all of these things, which really makes us something that could be created in a lab or created by a god. We just sort of drew liberally on things mythological that may or may not have played a part in all of this. It's a little like the Exodus, you know? That big sneak attack was sort of Pearl Harbor in space, and what was left, they figured they had to get away to fight another day. And one of their great hopes was that they might find kindred spirits out there across the universe, but they really don't know exactly where they're going. So that builds in a structure for a series. It's the journey and the trek that's the fun, not the reaching the goal. We played with all of the concepts we all grew up with and tried to press them and expand on them. Some shows had heavy underpinning in mythology, and some were, let's just do a good Western episode.
Skip!
You're trying to do things that are theatrical at the same time, a man who has the keys to, for example, the priesthood, which inspires and helps him to guide the fleet and so forth. That gets into Catholicism and into Mormonism. And we weren't anxious to try to go too far too fast. We didn't want to alienate anybody from their own convictions. We just wanted to throw things out there.
We ask for a sign to take us to Earth. And we ask for safety from Cylon. And look what has been given us, a madman.
Patrick McNee came aboard as a mysterious character who was really mythically, or in reality, supposed to represent the devil. And we once had a shot of him lying in the ashes, or so to speak. Studio wanted me to cut away from the shot because they thought maybe it was too on the nose. We shot it, but we didn't air it. We cut it.
Apollo, Starbuck, what are you doing?
Stay back.
I won't stay back. What is it you found?
Chibi, you don't want to go in there.
Let me go. I want to see.
You don't want to go in there.
I guess I should admit it for the first time on the DVD that what you saw was cloven hooves. We weren't afraid to go with it, you know, get out there in dark and light, even dealt with the possibilities of some translated people who have been translated into perfect beings, and did episodes with a ship of lights. There's a phrase in our theology, which the glory of God is intelligence. as man is, God was, and as God is, man may become. That's another phrase that actually comes from theology, and what it's suggesting is that there's a greater plan afoot for all of us to rise higher and higher. Perhaps run our own planet someday, you know, and be in charge because we did a good job either on Earth or out there in some of those planets. We really had fun experimenting and dabbling with these concepts. The only sorry part is that we didn't get a chance to play long enough.